Today we'll be taking a look at Scratch's statistics. I'm not talking about Scratch stats. I'm talking about this. If you scroll down all the way on the Scratch page, you can see all of these. And you might be familiar with the community guidelines, discussion forums, and Scratch Wiki. But under this, we have statistics. And as you can see, community statistics. And so many charts. So, let's go over them. So first, let's go to the community statistics at a glance. Now we have over 136 million projects shared, 112 million users registered, and 800 million comments posted, and 33 million studios. Okay, that's pretty crazy. And in the last month, they've had over 90 million page views. Alright, let's go over the monthly active trends. And we can see here, it goes all the way up to 20 million. Now, we can see here, new projects, new users, and comments. And comments are leading by far. Now, it doesn't look like that much at first, but whoa, look at that. And the highest spike was at 20 million comments in 2021. Alright, and if we just disable comments very quickly, we can see there's always a battle. So at first, we can see the users were spiking up, getting bigger, but now we have more new projects. And you can see it's always so spiky, like zigzags. And now it's going down again in the summer. Alright, let's put that back on. And we can see new users had their more spike in 2019 with 3 million users. Now let's go to the monthly active users, because that's what's actually important. So we can see a battle between project creators and comment creators. You can see mostly the project creators are winning, but sometimes the commenters can take a win too. As you can see here, every summer it goes down, but the project creators take a bigger hit and the comment creators actually win. And you can see it goes all the way back to 2007. So this is a huge list of statistics. Now let's look at the age distribution of Scratchers. And here you can see that most Scratchers are actually 12. And that doesn't really surprise me, that's like the prime age for being a Scratcher. And 11 million of them are 12. And next on the list is 11 and 13, so just around that age. Now what is surprising is that there is a spike at 18. So what I think is happening is that most kids, when signing up to a website, they'll just put 18, just in case something gets restricted if they're a kid or they can't use it. And you can see here, there are 200,000 Scratchers on 4. I don't think they're supposed to be here, but okay. And we can go all the way down. There is some spike in 33 for some reason, but mostly it's going all the way down, down, down. And 15,000 80-year-olds are still on Scratch. I wonder why it doesn't go on for longer, as I think there might be some 81-year-olds or 90-year-olds or something like that. But you can see, mostly it goes up, spikes at 12, and then goes down. It also seems that there aren't that many 17-year-olds. Maybe that's because of exams or something like that. Okay, now let's look at a map. And I love maps, I have another channel about maps too, so go subscribe to that. So here we can see Scratchers worldwide. And not surprising, the USA is number one. What is surprising though, is the number three, which is Poland. So most people would not be expecting this. And we also have Spain as one of the tops too. Now we have some expected ones too, like United Kingdom and China. And then we also have Australia. But what's also interesting is the lows. So if we look down here, we can see Antarctica at 0 people, which I think they just discriminated against Antarctica because a lot of Scratchers just set their location to Antarctica if they don't want the location to be shown. I used to do that, but then I changed it to Austria. And another one is the DRC, which only 260 people are from there. Which is surprising because it's such a massive country. And next we have Somaliland, which isn't independent yet. And we can see also 0 people. And even blends in into the white, so it just looks like it's part of the ocean. Alright, and we also have this white circle in the middle of Kazakhstan, and that just belongs to Russia. Okay, let's move on. Monthly project shares. Now we can see something surprising. So I always thought there were more new projects than remix projects, but there are actually more remixes, if you see here. And we could also change it to look like this and this. So that's pretty cool. But I think this way is just better. Monthly comment activities. Now this is actually really surprising. Like, I didn't expect this. So we can see profile comments are winning. I think this is like massively carried by Griffatch maybe. But yeah, profile comments of course are winning. But then studio comments. I thought project comments would be winning, but no, studio comments. Now, the more I think about this, the more this makes sense. Because studios are like a massive gathering of people, like a community can just gather in studio. So that should make sense. But still, I thought project comments would just be more popular. Anyways, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, leave a like and click on this video for more informational videos.